Well, look what followed me home today from the free cycle free-for-all. It's the same place I got the original iMac from last year. It's basically a flea market where everything is free. So you bring your junk, and other people bring their junk, and everybody takes what they want. And whatever people don't take, you just bring back home. And it didn't come with anything, so I'm just using the original keyboard and mouse from my older iMac. The one thing that I know is that I don't think the DVD drive is working. Because it makes that awful noise when you first turn it on. And I tried inserting a disc, and I got it all the way until the point where I could just barely pull it out again, and it didn't respond. The disc just sat there, so I don't know what's going on with that. Maybe there's a disc stuck in there. I don't know. I have to take it apart and see. It does have OS 9.1. I can put up to OS X 10.4 Tiger on it, which I'm planning to do. But it's kind of tricky because I looked on eBay, and a lot of the OS X discs that people are selling are specific to certain models, including some that only run on Intel processors, so I have to be very careful to get the version that would actually run on this, the original G3. So I'll see about that. It does have FireWire ports, which is nice, but the USB is still only 1.1, so that's really too slow to hook up anything modern. And it has all these kids games installed, as you would expect from an iMac. And whenever I turn it on, it asks me to insert this disc. So I noticed most of the games you try to start it up and it says please insert the CD. So they didn't do a full installation on the hard drive. I think out of 30 gigs, it still has like 24 gigs free. So obviously not that much stuff installed on it. Um, 256 megs, as you can see. I'm hating this mouse because you ultimately end up using it like that, which screws up your directions. So it's one of the worst designs Apple ever came up with. This stupid thing. Alright, system profile. You can probably hear the very noisy hard drive. I'll probably be putting in the 80 gig hard drive I put in my original iMac. I'll put it in this and probably put the original 4 gig back in the original iMac, because that's just from now on that'll just be a museum piece of how the original iMac was all set up, because I have this for more useful things. Let me see. 8 megs video memory, PowerPC 500 megahertz, has a 56k modem, Ethernet, hard drive, it's a Maxter, 30 gig. dvd-rom, it's a Machida, but I don't think it's working, and has built-in ATI video. I think they put better speakers in this than the original iMac, because it actually has some bass to it, which is a little surprising. So that's about it. What's this movie? Quick Time. See if this will play. No sound. It's just looping. Oh, kind of neat. So it definitely will be at its best with an upgrade to OS X and more memory, bigger hard drive, and a functional drive in there. So, but you can't ask much for free. I mean, I was surprised it even works because it's very dirty. It looks like rust on there, but I think that's just dirt. Wouldn't be surprised if there's dirt clogging up the DVD drive. So, it's going to need some upgrading and cleaning, but like I said, you can't beat that for free. So there you go.